They Reminisce Over You by Pete Rock and CL Smooth is, in my opinion, the greatest hip-hop song of all time. Made in 1992 as an ode to the group's friend Trouble T. Roy Dixon, who tragically passed away at the age of 22. This is a perfect song. With this beat alone, Pete Rock solidified himself as one of the greatest producers in music history, and CL Smooth gives us one of my favorite rap performances ever. This song is truly one of a kind. The whole thing feels bigger than rap. It's a piece of art where Pete and CL transported outside of themselves to give us something that connects with everybody whose ears it falls upon. The song starts with a 14-second sample of a group called The Beginning of the End. It's flipped in a chilling way that almost sounds like a train going into the afterlife until it fades into nothing. And then as soon as the horns kick in, you know you're in for a magical experience. This is one of the most iconic samples in hip-hop history. Everything about it feels classic. It's a flip of The Honeysuckle Breeze by Tom Scott and the California Dreamers. Pete Rock found this sample at the Princeton Record Exchange, which is actually my local record shop that I grew up going to, so I've always had an added touch of admirance for this song, as something that was built from the same records that I thumbed through. The fact that a song this beautiful and this important was made from just any old record that Pete found one day, that's really what hip-hop is all about. Taking something ordinary and making it into a culture-defining artifact. In the background of the beat, you'll hear whispers saying they reminisce, as well as a heavenly-sounding choir singing ooh. The song is about reminiscing over fallen loved ones, and its sound represents that flawlessly. It's not often that the beat of a song contributes to the theme of the track. Usually it's just the backdrop for the vocalist to paint the picture, but that's just what makes Pete Rock such an amazing producer. But every time this song is brought up, it's always about how amazing the beat is, but you cannot underrate CL Smooth's performance here. CL takes this opportunity to reflect on both Troy's life as well as his own, which I feel is one of the truest ways to write a song like this. If anyone close to you has ever passed away, then you know that losing someone so young will have you reflecting on your own life and mortality in new ways, and the way he does it here is just masterful. Every word that CL recites is poetically placed in the perfect way. He starts the song off by saying,
I reminisce for a spell, or shall I say think back, yeah. 22 years ago to keep it on track, the birth of a child on the 8th of October, like a toast, but my granddaddy came sober, count all the fingers and the toes, now I suppose you hope the little black boy grows.
He lets you know right away that you're in for a ride, with the most creative way possible to say that he looks back on his 22 years of life. It's poetry. He starts off the second verse saying,
when I take back, I recall a man off the family tree, my right hand, Papa Doc, I see. Woo. Took me from a boy to a man, so I always had a father when my biological didn't bother. Yeah.
These rhymes aren't overly complicated or anything. It's just the placement of the right words in the perfect place. The lyrics are incredibly personal to CL, however it's one of the most quotable songs in hip-hop to me, and CL interacts with the beat flawlessly. One of my favorite parts in the track is when he says,
not enough sleep to a jazz tune, I can hear his head banging on a wall in the next room.
I love how Pete's drums flare up right when he says this. The drums personify the noise of his head banging on the wall, helping me see the image of what CL is rapping about. The chemistry between these two in their prime was really unmatched. For the third verse, CL shines the light back on Troy and what he meant to the duo. CL raps about when he and Troy met, they got in a fight in the middle of the street, and then in the very next line he says,
but only you saw what took many time to see. I dedicate this to you for believing in me.
This line always hits me because you can tell that he meant it. The truth in this man's verses are so powerful. This was a real true friendship that he lost, and you can feel that. This song holds a special place in my heart because it's literally one of the songs that helped me fall in love with hip-hop. Rap wasn't prevalent in my life at all when I was younger, but my favorite video game, NBA Street Volume 2, had a soundtrack that introduced me to the culture. I had no idea that I even liked rap at the time, but that game had me listening to Just Blaze, Black Sheep, and Pete Rock all day as a 6-year-old. So yes, this may be a lot of nostalgia talking here, but I don't care. This song is perfect. Thanks for watching, everybody. I was gonna do a whole video on NBA Street Volume 2, but it looks like The Ringer beat me to it with their documentary that just dropped. Anyway, do you guys agree? Is this the greatest rap song of all time? If not, let me know in the comments what is the greatest rap song of all time to you. And as always, if you enjoyed the video, a like and subscribe is always appreciated. Thanks for watching, and rest in peace, Troy Dixon.